Teleportation. We see it all the time in the movies. I start here and end up here, crossing no physical space and in no time at all. But where are we at with actual teleportation? Well, it turns out we're already doing it in the quantum world. Thankfully, I have a scientist who's ready to explain it to me in the time it takes for an elevator to go up a very tall building. All right, beam me up! Ah, Andrea!
Hi!
So you taught me about quantum entanglement before.
Yes.
And today you're going to teach me about quantum teleportation,
yeah.
Right? Is it any easier?
It's not easier, but it's useful.
Okay.
So there's that.
Let's do it. What is quantum teleportation?
It's a way to transmit bits of information at a distance in a way that is unhackable. And the reason it's secure is because it uses pairs of entangled particles. For example, photons, where the zero is a horizontal polarization and one is a vertical polarization. Two photons are created entangled in opposite polarization, but you don't know which one it is,
mm-hmm.
Okay? They're just the opposite. Now, imagine on my computer, I have one bit of information,
mm-hmm.
and I want to send you that bit. Now, the photons get separated and sent to computer number one and computer number two.
Yeah.
When the photon arrives, and I measure it together with my bit, if, let's say, they become the same, that means this photon is a one, your photon has become a zero because it's created opposite to the one I've got. Right? Now, at this point, you haven't learned anything yet. You just got a zero as a random number. But then I can take the phone and call you and say, hey, Rad, my two are the same.
And because of that, I'll know
what bit I wanted to send you.
Yeah.
Because you have a zero. At the other end, there must be a one. And if I tell you my bit is the same, then you know I have a one. So now you've learned the bit of information I wanted to send you. So you're teleporting the information.
Right.
Now imagine someone is eavesdropping our phone call. All they're getting is same or opposite, which is completely random.
Right.
They're not learning anything. There's no way to hack it. It's been used, for example, in Switzerland 15 years ago in the local elections.
They 15 were used, years
yeah,
ago?
Yeah, yeah. And the vote was transmitted using this quantum teleportation method to the central voting station.
So weird.
It's not weird. Quantum
is
not weird. No, quantum is not weird. Quantum is not weird.
It's not weird.
Okay. It's just the way it works. You have particles that are created opposite by some natural processes, and then you just use that property of them being opposite to each other but not having a state of their own to do these clever tricks to transmit information that cannot be hacked.
You know what? I do think that this one was easier because it's useful.
Right.
When I can think of it in like real terms, that makes it so much easier.
Nice.
That was sick. Thanks.
Pleasure.
So quantum teleportation is a little bit complicated, so let me get settled in and get this right. So, quantum teleportation, it's a way of transferring information that is mostly unhackable, theoretically, if you get every part right. So it uses quantum entanglement, which, as I learned earlier, is when you have two quantum entangled particles that are always going to be opposite of each other. With polarity, one's going to be horizontal, one's going to be vertical. And even if you pull them apart from each other, they're going to remain opposite from each other. So, say I have a message. I'm at point A and I want to send something to point B. I first translate my information into something that can correlate with these polarities, say bits, zeros and ones, binary, we use it all the time in computers, and then I send two quantum entangled particles from myself and then to location B. And they're going to be opposites of each other. So when I look at my information that I want to send in relation to the quantum entangled particle, I can see if it's, for example, the same or different. Did it come out as horizontal or vertical in relation to my bits? And then when I know all that, I can talk to location B and say, hey, this one was the same, this one was different, this was the same. And they can work backwards from that to figure out what information I was sending because they have my entangled quantum particle. And this is unhackable because if someone else was to intercept a photon, or a quantum particle, I simply wouldn't get it. They would know that it wasn't there. And that by itself doesn't mean anything. It's only when it's correlated with the other information that it starts to make sense. Which is pretty cool, but also quantum is weird. It was a bit messy, but it was...
You're correct. But it gave the sense of suffering.
Hey, thanks for watching. If your brain is feeling a little bit like mush after all of those quantum mechanics, don't worry, you're not alone. But if you want to make it feel even more like mush, check out the other video that I did with Andrea. And remember to subscribe to ABC Science for more videos.